So let's talk about the Selective Colors tool in Photos. I'm using Photos version 3, which is the one that comes with High Sierra. And this tool is available in there. You have a photo that you're looking at and you hit the Edit button. And you have all of your adjustment tools. And one of them is Selective Color. So I'm going to hit the Reveal triangle there and you can see the interface. You've got Hue, Saturation, Luminance, and Range. You also have 6 slots here pre-filled with different colors. And you've got an eyedropper tool. Now, in order to change the yellow color to something else or to change its quality, I can select yellow. And now I can play with these different changes here. So I can adjust the hue. So I can go to the left to make it redder and go to the right to make it greener. I can change the saturation here. Making it extremely saturated, right, or desaturated all the way down to take all the color out. And I can change luminance, making it brighter or dimmer. Now, using these preset colors may not fit. Matter of fact, most of the time it's not going to fit what you need. Instead, what you want to do is select any one of these 6 slots here. Then use the eyedropper tool and then click somewhere in the photo that represents that color. So I'm going to click here and you can see it changes from red to yellow, a brighter yellow than the default one in the next slot. So now I'm going to get better results when changing. So I can go and say make this redder here, change its saturation, make it less luminant in this case, and keep playing around with these until I get something I like. And then I can compare that to the original image using the compare button here. So I click and hold down and that shows me my original, my release, and it shows me my adjustments. I can turn the entire selective color filter on or off with the check box here. So I can leave the settings in place, yet turn it off for now. I also have this undo button here that takes everything away and reverts it all the way back to its original. And I can basically change an image to either better represent what it is I saw or just make it something completely different. So let's look at another example. I hit the Done button here. I'll go to this album I've got which has various photos with different colors in it. So here's one of a chess set in a museum. I'll edit here. I'll select the first slot and then click the eyedropper tool and I'll select one of these tiles here to pick up that color. It works best when that color is not represented anywhere else in the photo, or if it is represented somewhere else in the photo, it's somewhere that doesn't matter. I've got a similar color here in the upper left, but I don't really care about that. So changing the hue isn't really going to affect things. So I can make it a different color here. And then I can adjust the range, and the range allows me to select what, you know, is affected. So it's going to be a pretty broad range at first, but I can drop that down and as soon as I see it not affect the part I want, then I can leave it right there. So you can see right there is not going to make much difference, but where that color is somewhere else in the image now isn't going to be as affected. And I can compare it to the original there. Let's look at another example. Here's lots of different colors here. And let's say I think that yellow box there is too distracting. And I notice there's not really any other yellow anywhere else. So I'm going to use the first slot here, the eyedropper tool, grab that yellow, and I'm going to decrease its saturation. If I decrease it all the way, you can see it's just basically black and white. I can leave it be a little bit yellow, but not as distracting as before. Maybe a little less luminant as well. So now it still has a color, but it isn't as bad as it was before where it kind of drew your eye away from it. And I could adjust the range down to the point where it's just barely affecting that one object. So any other bits of yellow aren't going to be as affected there. Now another thing you could do is you can use this to make colors really pop. So let's undo this here and I've got all these primary colors here. So I can click the red color and I could say let's make it more saturation, more luminance, and let's do the same for yellow Let's do the same for green and all of the rest of these primary colors here. And that makes this a much more colorful photo, so I can compare it to the original. It just makes things pop a lot more definition. I could probably accomplish the same thing using the color tool here if I wanted to. So there's always various ways to do things. I could probably also do the levels and curves to get this kind of effect here. And if there's something I really don't want represented as well, like say I really don't want the yellow because that box is popping out too much, I can then go the opposite direction with the yellow and let the other colors pop. I find this works best on photos where you don't either don't have people in them or you don't care about the color of their skin tone. Because if you have a portrait, you know, skin's got so many different colors in it that just about anything that you're going to affect is going to change how their skin looks. So you don't really want to do it like that. But here, you know, the people are just really small and in the back, you know, they're not the main element here. It's kind of the whole scene. So it kind of works. Also note that if you don't like using, you know, these sliders here, you do have the numbers there. And I can actually click in here. It's a little tricky. Sometimes you have to click a couple times. And I can set it to a specific number. So if I have something I like, I can actually use a number rather than trying to find that exact amount by sliding back and forth. So try out using selective color with some of your photos to make the color pop, to get rid of some color, to take away distractions, or to change something in your photos.